The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department is holding a briefing on President Marcos's official working visit to Japan. Let's listen in.
Monte of NHK. Will there be any security cooperation agreement that the two countries will be signing? If so, what could it be?
Well, thank you very much for that question. We are expecting the signing of an umbrella terms of reference on humanitarian assistance and disaster relief, or HADR, cooperation. This will be signed by the Department of National Defense and the Ministry of Defense of Japan. Yes, Japan has been a very important partner in providing assistance in relation to disaster relief. And we certainly welcome this agreement once it's signed. And aside from this agreement, there are other important agreements that are perhaps worth mentioning. The Secretary of Foreign Affairs will be signing an exchange of notes with regard to loan agreements on infrastructure, namely the North-South Commuter Railway from Malolos to Tutuban and the North-South Commuter Railway extension to Calamba, from Malolos, Bulacan to Clark International Airport and Tutuban to Calamba, Laguna. This will involve around $3 billion worth of loans that will be later signed also by the Department of Finance. Also, there is a proposed agreement on cooperation in the field of information and communications technology, which will be signed by the Secretary of Foreign Affairs on behalf of the DICT, because Secretary Uy will not be able to join the delegation. And finally, there will be a memorandum of cooperation between the Department of Agriculture and the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries on agricultural cooperation. As you know, the President heads the Department of Agriculture, but his senior undersecretary will be the one to sign this agreement with his Japanese counterpart.
Okay. Are there any questions from the floor? Okay, we have Joyce Balancho of ABS-CBN DZMM.
Sir, baka na may additional details ka po on the agriculture cooperation, memorandum of cooperation. Meron po ba tayo na-expect na, for example, exportation of Filipino products to Japan, yung mga ganong klase po?
Well, under PJEPA, we are already exporting a lot of agricultural products to Japan. Hopefully, this visit will result in more exports of agricultural products to Japan, especially our bananas and Hass avocado, which we hope will gain better market access in the Japanese market. Thank you.
Okay. There's another question here from the DFA Press, also from Ms. Monte of NHK. Is there any communication from the Japanese government regarding the Luffy case? And will it have an effect on the president's visit to Japan? Is there a likelihood that the deportation issue of the detained Japanese nationals in the Philippines be discussed during the president's bilateral meeting with FM Kishida?
This matter is being handled by the Department of Justice. If there is a decision to deport these the concerned Japanese nationals, the Philippines will follow the timeline of deportation proceedings in accordance with Philippine laws. And we feel that this is totally unrelated to the visit of the president. Now, this is a consular matter being handled by the Department of Justice and the Japanese embassy here, and our embassy in Japan with the Ministry of Justice of Japan in Tokyo. So we don't think it will affect in any way the visit of the president, and we do not expect it to be raised during his meeting with his counterpart.
Okay, thank you. Any further questions? I think we're good. Well, one more. Okay, Joyce again from ABS-CBN DZMM.
Sir, after Japan, what will be his next trip abroad?
Oh, I'm sure Malacanang will announce it once the calendar has been finalized for his next overseas visit.
Hi, sir, madam. Ian Hurst of GMA News. Sir, I know this is a sensitive issue, but will the president raise the issue on comfort of women during his visit in Japan?
Yes. We don't expect it to be raised, but the position of the Philippines on this issue is that compensation claims by former comfort women is considered to be already settled, no, as far as the government is concerned. All war-related claims are deemed to have been settled by our 1956 reparations agreement with Japan. No? However, the government will not prevent private claims should such actions be pursued by victims on their behalf or on their behalf. No? So we will not stop, of course, the victims, because this is an atrocious violence against women during the war. But as far as the government is concerned, we have already signed that reparations agreement with Japan in 1956.
Hi, sir. Good morning. Sir, Maricel Halili from TV5. Sir, just a quick follow-up about the business targets. During the visit of the president, do we have an estimate about the target or possible investment that we can gain from the visit?
Well, judging from the size of the business delegation, we were told yesterday that there are already about 150 who have signed up to join the business delegation from the Philippines, and the number of meetings and the business activities lined up for the president, we foresee a lot of business deals to be signed in various areas. And as for the estimated figure for investment pledges, we will leave that for the DTI to explain, no? Especially after the business meetings. I'm sure you'll receive information about this after the business events on the 9th and the 10th of February. But the economic portion of the visit is equally important, no, to this visit. And the president is devoting a lot of time, no, in ensuring that we are able to attract more interest from Japanese investors. And that we are able to sell more products for export to the Japanese markets.
Okay. If there are no further questions, this closes our briefing with Assistant Secretary of the Department of Foreign Affairs, Neil Imperial, of the Office of Asian and Pacific Affairs. Thank you very much. And we'll be back shortly with another briefing with the Department of Interior and Local Government. See you then. Thank you.
From Department of Foreign Affairs Assistant Secretary Neil Imperial detailing the scheduled official visit of Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos to Japan. Mainly, he spoke about the economic agenda that the Philippines is pushing forward, particularly in the fields of Japanese investments to the Philippines, as well as selling or exporting other Philippine products to Japan. Now, there is quite a big business delegation for this trip, about 150 from various industries, expected to hold meetings for their counterparts in Japan, expecting business deals in a lot of different areas. The briefing also covers the agenda on the terms of reference for humanitarian missions, especially in disaster relief. Mr. Imperial also spoke about infrastructure projects, which is high on the agenda, about $3 billion worth of loans from Japan to finance a lot of these infrastructure projects, main thoroughfares, highway projects, expressways, he mentioned. He also spoke briefly about expected cooperation and agreements with Japanese counterparts on information and communication technology. The trip is expected to nail various deals between agriculture officials of the Philippines and Japan. Of course, the intention of that is to increase exports of Philippine agriculture products to Japan.